John, thank you so much for coming on the show. That is a beautiful suit right there. That has to be custom made right there. That is.
Yeah, this is one of the many glorious neon outfits that you will see in this season of Neon Joe Werewolf Hunter.
So if anything, watch for the fashion.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of good looks. It's a lot of stunning. It's all neon. You know, it all different fabrics dye differently, and it just looks beautiful. And also, if I may, you know, we got this gorgeous hat, these amazing boots, and you might want to come in tight for the sweet belt buckle right there. Yeah.
Now, do you think that being a werewolf hunter, he wouldn't wear a werewolf, you know?
Well, he respects the animal.
Yeah.
You know, you have to respect your prey, otherwise you will be destroyed.
What is the, what's the phrase? It was a great catchphrase.
Heomp.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How would you spell that?
Here's how I spell it. Heomp is just a noise that Neon Joe makes. I spell it H-E-Y-U-M-P. Heomp. And it's basically just his kind of go-to thing.
Heomp.
Yeah, he oughta bada gotta heomp.
Now, what is it? What is it actually? Does it have a definition?
It doesn't mean anything, really. It's just kind of like, it's this unintelligible grunt, which was why one of the writers, Vernon Chapman, coined it. And it's just, you know, he's sort of vaguely Southern Cajun. We're not really sure. And he just kind of got a little bit of talk like this and got a heel. And so it just kind of, when there's...
I get it, got a heel.
I get it, got a good, I'll get a heel. He does speak. He doesn't speak gibberish. He does talk.
No, he says it. I heard that you can throw heel in songs and stuff.
Yeah, we did this thing when we were shooting, like between takes. We'd always, you know, me and all the actors and the crew, we would always, there'd be moments of trying to just think about whatever song you could work heomp into the lyrics. And it was always enjoyable if it kind of sounded somewhat like the lyric. For example, one of the best ones was that old song, Da Dip. And it became, you know, I put my hand upon your hemp. When you hemp, I hemp, we hemp. You put my hand upon my hemp. When you hemp, I hemp, we hemp. So, you know, it was like. Yeah.
Should we explain the origin
story?
Yes,
the origin of the show is I came on your show years ago when you were at 12:30.
That's right.
To promote the series finale of this other show that I made called Delocated, also on Adult Swim. And just to amuse myself, I thought it would be fun to just pair these two articles of clothing that I have that I use for live comedy bits. So again, arbitrarily paired together. It was a neon hoodie and these Coors Light sweatpants.
These sweatpants. No, I've never seen sweatpants like these things.
The dumbest. They just said Coors Light all over them.
Like, there's like, 800 Coors Light little logos, yeah. And then a neon sweatshirt and a neon hat.
A neon hoodie and a neon hat. Yeah. And so I just said, you know, I'm really sad. Delocated's done, but yeah. I'm excited for my new project. It's called Neon Joe Werewolf Hunter. All we have is the costume, but we're excited to figure out the rest.
This is a true story.
You can look it up and see it. It's not. Yeah. But anyway, so I thought at the time Adult Swim would watch this and think, we know that's a joke, but it sounds like a show we'd make. And that's exactly what happened. They called my bluff and said, yeah, that sounds funny, Neon Joe Werewolf Hunter. Why don't you, if you want to write a pilot? And I was like, all right. And I literally had nothing, because there was nothing. And so we came up with the script. We got to shoot a pilot, and now here we are at a second season. It's really, I have to say, favorite things about the show that it just came from this stupid
But I just
thing.
Love it because I'll do...
Oh, these comic books are so cool.
You got it. This is insane. John, look at this. Yeah. This is beautiful.
It's legit. DC did the comic. The covers are stunning. The interiors are really good. To have something so beautifully done for such stupidity is really kind of cool.
It's my favorite thing ever. What is going to happen in Werewolf Hunter's second season?
The second season
What do you call it? Like, you know, people have slang for their, like, if you work on Neon Joe Werewolf Hunter for years, what do you call it? You call it a hunter? Do you call it?
I don't follow the question.
Like, do you call it Neon? We're shooting our third season in Neon.
Oh, I see what you're saying. We'd probably just call it, third season of Joe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Had I known the answer, I wouldn't have asked the question. You make those mistakes. You know, what are you going to do, man?
Listen, not every story is meant to be told.
That's what they say. Yeah, absolutely.
So we're doing the second season.
Yeah.
Neon Joe is in a whole new town. If you have not seen the first season, I'm about to say a spoiler, so close your ears or turn your TV off. He has fulfilled his life's goal of killing his dad, who's also a werewolf. Mm-hmm. And that was his life's mission. So now, with nothing to do, he's going to figure out what's next. We allude to in the first season that he's going to open this tropical-themed bar called Oahu Joe's.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So Joe is in his bar with Cleve, and then a lot of elements from his past, flashbacks, people show up, and it opens up the world of werewolf hunting again.
And can we expect a couple of hints?
Oh yeah, there's a lot of hints.
All right, good.